So, hello again everyone, Genghis here, and today I have a 2-in-1 video for you, first part being of the JPE100. We are on the map called Live Oaks. I always forget map names, it's kind of incredible. Teams look rather even. They have a couple good players, we have a couple good players. There are 3 archers around, which is kind of scary for me. Because, well, you know. If you're in a JPE100 on a rather open map. Yeah. Now the spider was on stream and the peacemaker, the enemy T92, says hi to me. Now on one side that makes me happy because, you know, I get recognized. I say hey to people. It's always enjoyable if I recognize my viewers. But on the other side, he's in a T92 and I have that dirty feeling that he's gonna spend half his game aiming for me. So yeah. I don't feel too good about that, if you know what I mean. Anyway, I decide that with this amount of RT round and stuff, I just want to go city and help out there. As we don't have a lot of heavies, basically we only have a T57 heavy. And I expect at least a I-7, maybe a couple of turrets to go there. So, yeah, I'm proceeding to the city. Not much to say. I won't shoot you, says a T92. I don't believe that, says the JPE100. Now right now I'm debating if I should try and stop and shoot those guys, but as I got spotted by the 3090, I just want to get in cover as quickly as I can. Now I see a 268 there aiming for me, and luckily he misses. Honestly, if he wouldn't have, that would, you know, taking a third of my house away straight away. Would have been really bad. So as I kind of predicted, it's me and the T57 here in the city. However, what I didn't really predict was that the 268 would also come in the city. And on top of that, they're in a platoon, so that does not make them less dangerous. At all. So I really like this building here, it kind of gives you different forms of cover and it's already safe and stuff. See an I-7 coming, I pre-aim on the corner, I have a feeling he might come around. And boom, bitch. He got unspotted just before he came around the corner, but I already shot, and I managed to track him and do a nice meaty 1,000 damage, or nearly 1,000 damage to him. So that hurt him for sure. That basically took away half of his house, which is the power of this tank, no denying that. Now I tried to kind of sidescape here. It's a dangerous situation because of both RT and because of 2268, of which I don't know the exact position, but which could be pre-aimed here. So it's really possible that if I go around the corner, 2268s are gonna shoot me. Now they get spotted and I see one of them shoot, so I decide, okay, one of them just shot. Might as well eat a shot, I have more alpha. What?! I just one-shot an object 268 by ammo-racking him. Like, really? And our T57 manages to get 2 nice shots into the other one. So that was kind of a battle turner, or first battle turner here, because, well, you know, I took out one of the 3 tier 10s going city. And I decided I still have more alpha than that 268. But what? I Amorak a second 268? Like, 2 shots in a row? Amorak a 268 frontly? Wow. Just wow. I mean, okay, that Amorak wasn't from full life or anything, but. That was rather glorious. So I decided to push here. I'm hoping that I-7 won't spot me right now, because that would be fucking bad. Say it that way. He kind of notices me come, I guess, and I don't manage to snapshot him. So he's able to set up a side scrape. While he's doing that, I get into position here. The I-7 side armor is good, but when you have 300 AP penetration, if you manage to shoot the track or the part between the tracks and its based armor, you will be able to penetrate. If you shoot the spaced armor, it's a different story. But a side scraping I-7 is actually not as hard to penetrate as people seem to believe, and is nowhere near to as strong as a side scraping 100, for example. Oh, IS-4, for example. Now that was a really badly aimed shot by me, because I basically shot the mantlet of this SDA-1, which is the only base where I can possibly bounce. So yeah, good job to me. Right now I'm just aiming for the turret roof, and I penetrate that, and the T57 comes in to take him out. So yeah, while I've been kind of wrecking this side, our base has died, and I decide that I have to go back as fast as I humanly can, which of course I start doing. No surprise there. They have a Leo Proto and 250Bs in our base, as well as a couple other tanks, mainly M41 and T-34, which could also be pushing our base, but could also not be, so it's kind of hard to know. Now 150B is really low life, so that's good news for us. Also, really good news for me personally is that two of their arties got killed, which are the tier 9 and 10 arty, only the trade arty remains. So I'm a lot less scared now of being in, you know, open positions. Now I don't know what he was thinking, but our M41 Walker Bulldog decided to YOLO that 50B, which kind of obviously didn't work out too well for him. Sadly that T-34 gets unspotted just as he gets into my draw range, so I'm not able to shoot him anymore. But one of the 50Bs got taken out by now. So it's basically me and a T-57 and a Centurion against the 50B and a Leo Proto. While this is happening, I'm having like three eyes on the minimap, because I'm really hoping that Leopard 1 and Type 62 manage to win over there, which they do. Taking out the T-34, and they are now going to be able to either get in flank shots or pressure the other flank. Now I get spotted right here. It's not that surprising, could have been a lot of things. Looks like it was a 50B. I see him and I decide to go out and try and take a shot at him, but sadly he gets covered just too fast for me. However, looking at the minimap, I see him start to flank around, so I pretend to turn away. And then just before he pops around the corner, or I expect him to pop around the corner, I go back, so I am held down, and I aim at the corner, waiting for him to come, which he does. However, he sees me aim at him and just falls back. Now the T-57 died, and so did the Centurion, and so I'm basically now alone against the 50B, Leo Protopart, who's probably not a one-shot, and an M41. The M41 goes for it, but gets into cover before I could turn. And honestly, this is a really, 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 really bad situation for me. Like, the last thing you want to happen to you in a Leo, in a Jackpot C100 is to be alone against fast tanks. I noticed that Leo Proto stalked because he only did 200 damage to me. And I decide my only chance of survival really is to go and hug that building. And hope that support will arrive someday or something. Now the 50B got taken out by now, I think it was a Leopard, must have been. So it was some nice sniping, and the M41 does a dash for it. And I managed to take him out with a really nice snapshot, shooting through destructible cover. Now apparently I'm a hacker. If you can explain me what makes me a hacker, I would be really glad. But yeah, the T92 though says I'm just awesome, which I find kind of hilarious. So yeah, now it's me against a Leo Proto. It's going to be hard for him to attack me because, well, if I get lucky I can high roll him, but mainly I have this building as cover. And what I'm doing right now is getting distance between me and the building. Now that might sound stupid, but basically right now it's impossible for him to move away from the building. Because on both sides I can shoot him, I can turn fast enough. And now as soon as I get unspotted, I start driving forwards. I want to try and surprise him and get a shot into him. I decided to try to go aggressive now. Especially as he's stock, he's not that dangerous. Yeah, I was actually turned around, but I just managed to snack shot in. Sadly, I do roll high, but I don't roll high enough. And I leave him on 20 HP. Tried to ram him here, but he just manages to dodge it. As you might be noticing, I'm loading HE. Because in case he's, for example, trying to do a weird side script on me or something, I can then take him out easily. Sadly, he gets around the corner just before I reload. Now we're back to the old situation. But he does something stupid there, and I take him out. So, let's have a look at the post-game stats of that game. As you can see, I got my ace tanker. Oh, not my ace tanker, I got another ace tanker. However, what was new, I got 2 marks of excellence on this tank now, which I'm rather happy about, especially as I don't play that often. I also got a rather unsurprising high caliber medal. If we have a look at the stats, I did 7,759 damage, combined with 4 kills and a tiny bit of spotting damage. I also traveled nearly 2 kilometers, which, considering the speed of this tank, speed, is not too bad either. I think this was a really nice carry with some nice draw moments, like when I killed the M41 or when I Amarak 2 Object 268s in a row. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, well, of course, it's only part 1 of the video, but remember to leave me a like, and I'll be right back with part 2, showing you an awesome KV5 game. Here we are in the KV5, it's on Muravanka, well, it's a tier 8 game, rather nice matchmaking, there are a couple of tier 7s around. However, what I don't really like is the amount of TDs. Even tier 7 TDs can really hurt this tank, especially those ones with that a Sture Emil, which is really high penetration, and SU-152s, which, well, if they manage to penetrate with AP or heat, you lose a lot of health, and if they just shoot HE, you're going to lose a lot of HP anyway. I'm going to go on the left because, well, that's where the gap is and there's some nice buildings I can use. I'm not going to say that's the best thing you can do on Numa Ravranka. I've honestly still have to try out this map. I only got it 3 times since the patch came out, and it's not like I've not been playing, as you know if you've watched my stream. But yeah. I get recognized once more. Always nice when people say hi gangers or something to me. But well, what much is there to say right now? We have a couple of Russian heavies, like I-3, I-6, KV-5, all of the G8 Russian heavies are represented there. They only have a Tiger II and an I-3. We also have a Tiger II. But they have a lot of support tanks in the form of an Isu, a 5100, which is really dangerous with his matchmaking, and so on. And as I already mentioned, all those tier 7 TDs. Now I'm gonna go make a dash straight for those buildings. Even if I might get shot on the side by some faster enemies, who could be up on the hill or that comet. Right now I have a really bad crew in this tank, my IS-8 crew. My IS-8 crew is much worse than my IS-3 crew. So I don't even have 6 cents, so that's really a, you know, disadvantage. Try to take a shot on the move there at the T-43, but doesn't connect as I wish it would. But an X-1 does, so it's not too bad. Honestly, it's one of the things I like the most about the KV-5, is that the accuracy on the move is really... I mean, it's not like G110E5 or T-62A level, but that would just be retarded. But it's really good. Sadly, I don't manage to penetrate my shot there on the IS. They are capping with 3 guys, so, well, I have to decap. Now, I've already decapped the T-43 a couple of times, he's not got a lot of cap points. But the IS and the Comet... And wow, there's also a Tiger in the cap? Like, oh my god. Already putting some pressure up. There's also... Well, there is a... Managed to get a bit of time there by decapping the Tiger, but he actually didn't have a lot of cap points. Our IS goes in the cap for a couple seconds, buying a bit more time. But now the cap is rising really fast, and I decide, okay, I don't have shots from here, I have to go forward. Even if I'm gonna show my flank to, like, every tank out there. Now I get really unlucky there, missing the IS completely. Should have been a pretty sure penetration. And I miss him again. Really? Now there's an IS-3 there, but honestly I shouldn't even be shooting him. Not with the gap rising like it is. And now the gap keeps rising, like it's at 90% now, or 90 cap points, whatever you want to call it. And it's not. I've loaded APCR, which enables me to penetrate the IS, but he hardly had any cap points. So, wow. When the cap was at 99%, I managed to decap that comet, which basically saved the game, for the moment at least. And now it's actually the T-43 who has a lot of cap points, and I should be focusing my fire a lot more. Sadly, I get a bouncer because the ice is doing a good job of hiding. The I think that was a Sture Emil put a shot into me, but I decide I want to take out this comet. He has the most dangerous gun of all, and then I change my opinion and I want to kill the one shot. I was tracked there and I felt like that was why I was getting damaged so much, so I repair my track and I start the awesome wiggling. And I've basically, the cap is not a problem right now. I managed to take out the comet. And the IS is suddenly kind of scared of me after I destroyed all his friends. But he dies just before I can take him out. I decided to load APCR again because that IS-3 still has rather decent armor. And yeah, I'm really low life right now. Like, one HE shot was gonna take me out. And I get a... well, I guess it was a deserved bounce and a badly aimed shot on the IS-3 there. But, whatever. I get a kind of lucky shot there into the Tiger's 2 side when he was just turning through the building wrecks. And I know I reload first. Try and shoot him again, but that time I hit the pillars of the building. I guess. Yeah, now the game is won. I mean, the game was never really close by tanks or anything. The only point where they nearly won was a snapshot for the win. When the gap was at like 99%. So, do I manage to get the kill? Nope, I don't. I should have probably stopped and aimed the shot, but whatever. Let's have a look at the post-game stats, and I swear you might have a surprise or two. So, as you can see, I only got a first class, but that's not too surprising as I only did... oh, only 700 damage and 3 kills, even if that got me 1,340 raw experience. However, well, I got a Spartan, which means... I survived a bounce when I had less than 10% HP remaining, a high caliber, a defender, and a steel wall. Let's have a look at the detailed results. I fired 25 shots, of which only 15 penetrated, but that's not too bad considering how much, only 18 hit, which is not too bad considering how much I was snapshotting and shooting on the move, giving me that total of 3,700 damage. However, I received 31 shots, of which 17 did not penetrate, and even the 14 which did penetrate did not manage to kill me, which just shows you how much HP this tank has. And I blocked 6,010 damage with my armor. So people like to ramble on about the KV5's armor, but at medium distance, if you're wiggling and you're not fighting very high penetration enemies, with which I mean tier 8 TDs and tier 9 tanks, the enemies have to basically hit your R2D2 cupola, or maybe your turret if they have a high penetration like an IS-3, or of course if they're shooting gold. And honestly, the armor of this tank is really good, especially the side armor. You can really show your side armor at like a 45 degree angle, and you're gonna bounce so much from, you know, tier 8 mediums and tier 7s and whatever is out there. And also, I managed to get 115 base defense points, which is, a rather decent result, I would say. I earned 120,000 credits brutto, for which I got 86,000 netto, which is also due to me shooting, I don't know, around 5 shots of APCR in that game, maybe even a bit more. And I got a nice double with an event, which gave me 5,226 XP. I hope you guys enjoyed this double video. If you did, please leave me a comment, leave me a like, leave me a share, mainly shares of what I need, and of course, subscribe to my channel and my Twitch channel for more awesome live action. See you next time, bye bye, Genghis.